Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
And welcome. We sign ourselves in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with all of you today. And as we go before the Lord, we pause, acknowledging our sins, so we can celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do, and through my fault, in my fault, and my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary of the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord of our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Bless us, Lord, our God, with the virtues of the heart of your Son, and set us aflame with his love, that conformed to his image, we may merit a share in eternal redemption. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Amen.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, thus should one regard us, as servants of Christ and stewards of the mysteries of God. Now it is, of course, required of stewards that they be found trustworthy. It does not concern me in the least that I be judged by you or any human tribunal. I do not even pass judgment on myself. I am not conscious of anything against me, but I do not thereby stand acquitted. The one who judges me is the Lord. Therefore, do not make any judgment before the appointed time until the Lord comes, for he will bring to light what is hidden in darkness and will manifest the motives of our hearts. And then everyone will receive praise from God. The word of the Lord. The salvation of the just comes from the Lord.
The salvation of the just comes from the Lord.
Trust in the Lord and do good, that you may dwell in the land and be fed in security. Take delight in the Lord, and he will grant you your heart's requests. The salvation of the just comes from the Lord. Commit to the Lord your way, trust in him, and he will act. He will make justice dawn for you like the light. Bright as the noonday shall be your vindication. The salvation of the just comes from the Lord. Turn from evil and do good, that you may abide forever. The Lord loves what is right and forsakes not his faithful ones. Criminals are destroyed and the posterity of the wicked is cut off. The salvation of the just comes from the Lord. The salvation of the just is from the Lord. He is their refuge in time of distress. And the Lord helps them and delivers them. He delivers them from the wicked and saves them, because they take refuge in him. The salvation of the just comes from the Lord.
And the Lord be with you. Scribes and the Pharisees said to Jesus, "The disciples of John the Baptist often fast and often pray, and the disciples of the Pharisees do the same, but yours eat and drink." And Jesus answered them, "Can you make the wedding guests fast while the bridegroom is with them? But the day will come when the bridegroom is taken away from them. Then they will fast in those days." And he also told them of a parable. No one tears a piece of new cloth to patch an old one. Otherwise, it will tear the new, and the piece from it will not match the old cloth. Likewise, no one pours new wine into old wineskins. Otherwise, the new wine will burst the skins, and it will be spilled, and the skins will be ruined. Rather, new wine must be poured into new wineskins. And no one who has been drinking old wine desires new. For he says, the old is good. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Towards the end of the Gospel there, we had a parable. And the parable is old wine into new wineskins. And often you stop to think about that, that probably is not a good idea because the wine will have a different effect on the wineskins once it's placed in there. And probably it wasn't seasoned correctly to do so, to accept the wine. But if you stop to think about it a little bit, Jesus is doing a parallel or using an analogy on that of the conversion of heart. When Jesus came into the world, okay, he was fulfilling what the Old Testament prophecies talk about, the Messiah coming in, and also he was fulfilling the law of the Old Testament. He was not changing it, but he was enhancing it and moving it forward into a whole new dimension rather than what the people thought the law was about at that time. And so that's what was his challenge ahead, okay? But also what was the challenge that he did face was their concept of the Messiah as well. And that Messiah they had in mind was a warrior type that would take the people and free them from that of the oppression of the Romans. But Jesus came into the world as a fulfillment of the Old Testament. And the fulfillment of the Old Testament was the Messiah who is going to suffer, die, and rise, but also is one who's going to free them from the oppression of sin. And most of us probably heard, "Reopen the gates of heaven." We've heard it from the time we were small. And so that's what his mission was. And so, you know, as people go about listening and having a change of heart, a change of an idea or a metanoia, okay, what will happen is they could not go back to their old ways. They could only move forward. And that's what Christ was talking about. New wine into new wine skins. So, you know, for all of us, sometimes we like the old days, and that is true, or the way things used to be. But, you know, there are times when we have to face the reality that says, well, we're moving towards a new era, a new direction. And, you know, with the pandemic that's going on, okay, we like the old ways. We're kind of like set in them. And it's challenging us to move into a whole new norm, a whole new reality, but still maintaining the faith that we had and build upon that faith, knowing that God's going to be with us during those transitions or change of heart, maybe. So, you know, what is happening there? New wine into new wineskins. Sometimes we would like to go back to the old, but we're not going to be able to do that. But we need to move forward and deal with what we have and ask the good Lord to help us with that. And that could be a challenge for everybody, no matter how old or how young you may be. So what we're asking the Lord today within the liturgy is to give us what we need to meet those challenges, but also make the adaptation, okay, that we need to see the world in the way that it is at the present moment, but also to bring our faith into it, because the God who was there before is going to be continuing to be there at the present moment and in the future. And the Eucharist is one of the things that could help us with that. We come in contact with the Lord, and we form the living body of Christ, because we have the same faith that we when we come to receive the Eucharist, and give us what we need to meet those challenges, but also to help us to adapt to new wine and new wine skins. And let us pray for God's people today. We are praying for the church, that it continues to be a beacon of light, a beacon of hope, and a beacon of justice. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who are traveling, that they reach their destination safely, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We also pray for those who have died, that they be shared in God's eternal presence. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for those who are sick, especially those, the people we know, our friends and relatives, whomever they may be, that the Lord will provide comfort for them this day, and they will feel our prayers for them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we pray for those who have special needs in any way, people who are experiencing injustice in some way, for those who are hungry, for those who thirst for holiness, for those who are struggling economically, for those who are living in foreign lands for one reason or another, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. And so, Lord Jesus, we stop and we gather our prayers and we offer them once again to you. You know what they are before we ask, but we ask them anyway. For you have often said, "Seek, you shall find, knock, and the door will be opened to you." We have just done so. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. And let us pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours is acceptable to God the Father, the Almighty.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for all the world. Good God, Father of mercy, give you cause of your great love, which you love us. With untold goodness, give your only begotten Son, grant me pray that being perfectly united with him, we may offer you worthy homage through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord. It is truly right to trust our duty and salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, my Father, my eternal God. For you raised up on high the cross, on the cross. He gave himself for us with a wonderful love, and poured out blood and water from his pierced side, the wellspring of the church's sacrament, so that, won over to the open heart of the Savior, all might draw water joyfully from the spring of salvation. And so the angel
a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and giving it thanks, he said the blessing. Gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this all of you and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Save us,
Savior of the world.
For by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection, and his ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Lord, we pray upon the oblation of your church and recognize the sacrificial victim by whose death you will reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we were nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with the Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit of Christ. May you make us eternal offering to you, so that we may attain the inheritance of your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs and all the saints, on whose constant intercession your presence we rely on our failing help. And may this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your local church on earth, your servant Francis, our Pope, Frank, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your memory. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family who has summoned before you. In your compassion and merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at this passing from this life, give the kind of entrance to your kingdom. That we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him in it, O God, Almighty Father, in unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. And so we pray in the words of Jesus as follows. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day.
Lamb of God,
so you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, so you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, so you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold, Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Bless us all to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, when you say the word, my soul shall be healed.
Take partakers in this sacrament, the chaplain. We humbly implore your mercy, Lord, that we may be conformed to Christ here on earth and merit to be co-heirs of his glory in heaven, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
And the prayer for Father Grison.
Lord Jesus, who has told us, ask and you shall receive. We address our prayers to you through the intercession of your priest, who is Grison. Attentive to the signs of the times and in obedience to your will, he founded the double family of the Almighty Sisters and the Almighty Sisters. Confident in your providence and joyful in your will, he knew his good father now to make himself all things to all people. Grant us through his intercession the favors we ask of you especially.
And may the Holy Church rejoice.